For this map, we wanted to give players a whole new experience. Before, it was maybe like a marathon, but I think for this one, just because the map's so small, instead of a marathon, this map is more like a 100-meter dash, nonstop action.
What is the map's identity? What are the big notes this map has to hit to be considered kind of awesome and unique?
How do we set up a smaller map that also has the same kind of intricacy that the other maps, two maps we have, Miramar and Wrangell?
My job is kind of coming up with a lot of fun locations I think players would enjoy visiting, and then kind of working with all these really talented individuals to bring it together.
VR에 저희가 추가하고 있는 배틀로얄 게임 플레이를 더 심화하는 일을 해야겠다는 생각을 하고 있었고, 동시에 다양한 배틀로얄 플레이를 유저들에게 그 경험하게 하고 싶다라는 어떤 의지가 있었어요.
The beginning, we knew we wanted a small map. We wanted it to play fast, and I seriously believe as long as it's fun, it can be in any location. So we had a few different ideas. We talked about Pacific Northwest. We talked about Southeast Asia. We talked about the Australian Outback, and then we kind of jumped in a room with TS and the other stakeholders and had discussions of what would feel like the most fresh departure from Miramar.
We want to give our players a new experience every time we try a new map. And we already did Europe and we did South America. So I guess the natural process was to continue and pick a spot that we haven't touched before, which was Southeast Asia.
So you go from these hot sands of Mexico right into this like overgrown lush jungle landscape.
정말 실제 리얼한 월드를 만들려는 하는 게 목표이기 때문에 실제로 저희가 뭐 다른 프로젝트처럼 원화가가 없이 원화가 그 그림을 그리는 게 아니라 실제 있는 데 가서 찍던가 자료 인터넷으로 자료 조사해서 분들을 자료를 찾고 그걸 작품을 모델링 하기 때문에 저희 생각에는 최대한 리얼하게 있는 월드에 실제 세상이 있는 건물을 갖다 놔야 이게 진짜 리얼하게 이게 맞다고 생각하기 때문에 그런 좀 힘들어도 그게 하려고 자료를 최대한 모으려고 그렇게
For Sanuk, we took a different approach in the production where we try to implement a process called photogrammetry.
We find an object, get a color card reference of it, and then we start taking photos. Typically 50 to 100 is a good range of photos. And then we feed those photos into reality capture, which is the program that converts all the photos, stitches them all together, and actually makes the point cloud that becomes the model.
From then on, we still have to touch it up because it's not perfect and we still have to optimize it. And when that's done, we get the 3D asset and we put it in the game.
When we're putting this map together, we have these locations and we're just kind of like spitballing. Then resort came up. So we found, you know, reference shots of abandoned resorts in Southeast Asia.
So we thought, God, let's just go there and shoot. We're going to Southeast Asia. We're jumping in a plane and we're getting some cool stuff.
And our team from Seoul and Madison went to do that trip.
We wanted to find a location that had a good cross-section of everything that we needed. We found a good coastal location that also had mountains. The main focus of the trip was to get some in-person reference that we weren't really getting from just the internet, and that really paid off. We weren't really concerned about having perfect footage when we were done, or even stuff we could use in the game. We managed to get both.
We strongly feel that the art should follow the fun. So the first thing we do is we have a lot of talks about how this thing should play. Off the bat, we wanted to have something simple, fast. We focused on really simple architecture, really easy to navigate. And from there, we kind of spread towns around. And really, we were looking for, is it fun before the art follows? It starts with the concept. We knew we wanted something that played fast. It should be accessible to new users. It should feel like a breath of fresh air after Miramar. So with those goals, we made some decisions up front to kind of limit most gameplay to first and second story building. So it's very simple, not too crazy. And from there, the design and our terrain artists make a really, really rough version of the map.
게임 플레이 측면에서는 유저들이 많이 다르다고 인정해 주시는 부분인 게 아까 말씀드린 대로 접근성이 높고 게임 플레이 타임이 굉장히 짧고 빠른 전투가 벌어지고 굉장히 전투 시간이 짧고 그 안에서 루팅은 굉장히 풍족하고 전투에 집중할 수 있고 죽더라도 부담 없이 어떤 다른 세션으로 빠르게 도전할 수 있고
We wanted it to be fast. We wanted it to be accessible. So that means getting to the fun stuff faster, right? I want to have rifles. I want to kick ass sooner. You know, I want a hot drop. So really trying to make that first appetizing bite for PUBG for our audience was the goal right from the beginning.
What sets Sonak apart from the other maps is more traversal ability for boats gameplay that we couldn't have before in other maps. Obviously, the smaller space leads to more chaos and more gameplay that players are looking for to test their gun skills. And just simpler design and overall, so it's much more easier for players to find each other, which will obviously lead to more unpredictable spaces where people can do things.
큰 점이 하나 있는데, 에란제 같은 경우에는 블루존이 가만히 있는 시간이 되게 커요. 그리고 블루존이 이동하는 시간이 되게 짧고 되게 빠르거든요. 산업은 반대로 대기 시간이 되게 짧습니다. 그리고 블루존이 천천히 이동. 이게 두 개가 완전 다른 개념인데요. 에란제 같은 경우에는 건물을 장악하고 있으면 되게 게임을 유리하게 플레이할 수 있습니다. 하지만 산옥은 건물에 오래 있을 수가 없기 때문에 이동을 하면서 적들을 봐야 되고요. 이동하면서 자신의 건플레이 스킬 같은 게 더 중요해요.
In my first Korea trip, I said, why don't we just open this thing up? 4 days later, it was decided we were doing open development. And that was really scary because it's like, uh-oh, now I have to deliver this map and it has to look cool and everyone's going to see it way early, like way before they should see it. So that was insane to get that first version of the map out and actually have like the streamers respond to it. You're getting feedback sooner. You can fail fast. Right from the jump, we're hearing if people like what we're doing or if they don't. It's so early in development that if people aren't responding to layouts or towns or unique areas, there's plenty of time to make adjustments based on that feedback.
테스트, 이게 유저와 소통하면서 이터레이션을 돌면서 개발한다는 게 핵심이고 그 과정상에 유저가 원하는 게임 플레이를 실제 게임에 반영해서 유저들이 원하는 콘텐츠를 만든다는 게 이제 핵심이라고 보시면 되고요.
제가 숫자를 다시 또 튜닝하고 다음 테스트에서 그게 개선되는지 아니면 더 나빠지는지 확인하고 또 계속 작업했습니다.
그것도 산옥에서부터 처음 시도한 게 아니라 이제 처음 저희 맵 에란게 개발했을 때도 아마 모르시는 분은 많을 거예요. 그때 워낙 이름 없는 데라서 사람들이 모르는 사람도 많고 그래서 그냥 최대한 그냥 피드백 받아서 수정해 나가는 과정을 했었어요. 근데 이제 산옥은 이제 워낙 이제 저희가 유명해지다 보니까 이제 그런 오픈 디벨로먼트라고 하는 것 자체를 정말 좋게 사용할 수 있는 예가 된 거고요. 정말 저희가 재밌게 즐겁게 플레이해줬으면 좋겠다는 생각으로 만든 맵. 정말 사람들이 즐겁게 즐길 수 있는 맵을 만들고 싶었다.
I'm really excited just to see how all the different types of players we have that haven't yet played the map yet, just to run around it and see what they see and what they think. I'm really looking forward to it.
The Korean design team, our designer here in Madison, that was their singular focus, was to make sure that if this is your first time playing PUBG, you're going to have a really good time and you're going to get to the action fast and it's going to pump you full of adrenaline. You're going to want to come back and play it again.